Hi. Hello. We've made it. Today, this moment right here. This is the convergence of several things, all of which are kind of my fault, except for one I take no credit for. First off, let's talk. Let's speak. Let's talk. Hi, how are you doing? Okay. I as much as I've like hyped this up, I have no plans. I have the general idea of what's going on, but I didn't prepare a script or anything. Anyway, basic rundown. Today is a lot of things. As you can see on the descriptor at the top, this is the 100th stream of mine. Way back, early January, obviously, New Year's shenanigans, I set out myself a goal to push myself to greater heights and greater power. One of those was to get my visual appearance that you are viewing currently, which I did. The other of the ones that are like vague and tangible and quantifiable, was to do 100 streams. And there have been a lot of streams this year. But this moment, particularly, is the 100th one that I hosted. There was Epilogue, those were hosted by Quint. I did some collabs with other people on their streams. But right here, this one, right now, is stream number 100. Fulfilling a grandiose goal that seemed a little shaky at times, but I managed to pull through. It is also, in case you are wondering, United States Thanksgiving Day, so I picked the perfect day to accomplish this personal goal on. I'm very, very thankful for all the things that have happened to get me to this point, and I'm very thankful to all the things in the wings that are currently helping me get to further points. This year was mostly just about personal resolve, commitment, and development as we go on to just making everything work and be good and stuff. And now we're there, and I don't really know how to talk about it any further, so I'm just going to leave it at that, and I'll just gush sentimentally throughout the rest of the stream anyway. Now, on to business, because this stream is not just me standing here talking about it. This stream has a point. I had two big passion projects this year. One was the whole 100 stream things, but the other was my Empire at War modded playthrough. Not just modded in that I played a mod, but modded in that I modded the mod to put me and the other two INTTV members at the time into it as playable character. It was an RTS, it's not really playable. As commandable units. And that went well, and that had like the most production value I put into any stream series ever, with a custom map, custom drawings, custom game. And we won. We won. It was back in about like April, early May, I'm not sure. We beat the entire campaign. Insurmountable odds, the galaxy under our control. I'm working on a video, or a series of videos, depending on how long it is, turning it into like a war documentary. I mentioned me wanting to do that before, but now editing is actually underway. Expect it to be done in like 5 years, given how long the Clubhouse Games highlight went, and the fact that I'm the one doing it this time and not Lark. But I left one thing unresolved, unfinished. In the far corner of the galaxy, forgotten by time, lays the remnants of the Infinite Empire. A threat to our remade galaxy. Our remade empire. It must be destroyed for us to be kept safe. And there is no victory that leaves this threat uncontested. So, it is time to return. Let us begin the tactical analysis. Yeah, that's right. We're getting the tactical music out in here. Let's begin. I welcome you all back. To the one, the only Endor War Room. All right. So, here is the situation. Over here, sitting uncontested in the depths of the galaxy, is the one and only Infinite Empire. Rakata Prime, no longer in its prime, but an unquestioned threat the galaxy has not forgotten completely. We are at the moment right before our ultimate victory. The severed fleet stands at the corporate sector, ready to invade its ground forces. But we cannot do this. This will end the campaign once and for all. We need to go back. We need to destroy the Starforge and then take the corporate sector. Our plan for doing that is very simple. Take the severed fleet, bring it all the way back across the galaxy to Rakata Prime. Take Rakata Prime, then patch all of the shattered pieces of what we lose. While we're doing this, the rest of the galaxy will try and retake territory. The Imperial defectors are spreading. They have been moving out into kind of the mid-rim, sort of, near the... They're taking over the wedge, basically. And if they take Hape's Cluster, they are going to completely contest our ability to conquer the galaxy. The Calamari Sector also stands vulnerable, as does Droman Kaas. It is pretty evident to me that we will lose a lot of territory doing this major diversion. Meanwhile, our path back to Rakata Prime is going to be very simple. We take the path we took the Severed Fleet into this sector of the galaxy and go backwards. Through Korriban, Felucia, Tiliana, all the way through. Once we get to Tanab, we should be home free to just push through all the way into the Utigar Nebula, to the Redoubt, to Chila, and to Rakata. I am going to try and produce a lot of, like, small ancillary defense forces throughout the galaxy just to hold the line for as long as it can to try and make the recovery process once we take Rakata a bit less painful. I should also mention that it is absolutely in no way, shape, or form guaranteed that we will take Rakata. But I have faith in the Severed Fleet. It has me in it. It has Rose. It has Quint. It has a Praetor that we just sort of built. And if we could push through, conquer the entire galaxy, what's one more planet, huh? What's a 30,000-year-old ancient relic gonna do, huh? I'll tell you what it's gonna do. It's gonna wipe the floor with us, but we're gonna wipe the floor with it while it's wiping the floor with us. The floors are going to become very clean today. There is no other plan. Destroy Rakata Prime. Now, I would love to do a cool dramatic entry into the next thing right now, but truth is, I do not actually have a way to concisely transition to the next game, so... If you'll just bear with me for a second as I go and load the game and do all that stuff, we can casually enjoy that experience. Let me just boot the game. I've prepared everything, don't you worry. In the meantime, how are you doing? Oh, there's the executable. You may hear a noise coming soon. Glad you're doing great. I think we are clear to transition to the game. So allow me to do that once it loads properly for once and for all. Okay, we're past the main menu, so I think we're safe to go. So let's go. Wait for it. Wait for it. You waiting for it? I'm waiting for it. You better wait for it. Because it's showing up. There we are. Welcome back. You may be wondering where I am. I cannot be present on the screen today because I'm already in the game. Let us load. I welcome you to the war once more. Now, I should also mention that just a general statement of other great news. About 3 days ago, Empire at War, the vanilla game from 2006, got an update. It's now 64-bit, providing more RAM for all of your super load-bearing mods, more multiplayer stability. You can play multiplayer mods with this thing now. It is great. We are back. Pause the game immediately. We need to reestablish ourselves real quick. Okay, oh, it's been so long, I missed it. So, what are we doing? First off, where am I? Here am I. The classic trifecta, the severed fleet stands ready. But we cannot stay here. We need to go back. So, here's the corporate sector. If we were to invade the land battle here, we would win. But we cannot do that. We must go back. Zygeria, Malachor, Dromenkos, Korriban, Felucia, Liana, Colonex possibly, Ringo, Vinda, Roche, Lantilles, and then we proceed. We also need to prepare a route forward from this side. I believe that the Separatist holdouts have taken Doran's space control. So if we can find just some random latent star destroyers just mulling about, we can use those to close the gap, so to speak. I don't believe there's anything of particular value in between here and there, but oh, you can see the Imperial defectors are currently in the process of taking Mandalore before our very eyes. The Hapes cluster stands defended with a Lucre Hulk and 3 ISD-2s. Brentel has a very powerful land fleet, not that it matters to us much. The Borlaeus sector, okay, so I think we focus just build some Star Destroyers everywhere we can. If it's got a level 3 station, we're building an ISD-2. If it doesn't have a level 3 station, we're building a victory class. Frankly, this is well overdue. Production started. And there is the Mandalore. Actually, no, that's the Lorinar invasion fleet. Good to know that the Imperial defectors are being active. Glad we took out an Allegiance class, though. All that said, we need to move, we need to go. The corporate sector, we need to get the severed fleet moving. Hold on. We've accidentally invaded the corporate sector. Hold on. You know, okay, you know what? We can do that. Okay, we'll just leave. We'll show up, we'll say that we can take the planet, but we're not actually allowed to. We can't take the corporate sector. The game will just end. We will say hi, though. In fact, this might be a perfect opportunity to soften up the defenses a little bit. You know, just while we're in the area. No reason I can't be tactical. Oh, frick, right, it's one of these maps, huh? Yeah, you know what? How about no? How about no, actually?
Our reinforcements are taking casualties.
Yeah, I getcha. We're not mentally prepared to deal with this right now. We have an infinite empire to take down. Come on, rev up the engines. Let's get out of here. There we go. Wow, they have aircraft. Corporate sector is not messing around, huh? You know, it's classic corporate sector shenanigans. Okay. That's the Mandalore invasion. We cannot oppose that. Okay. Move out. Column X seems to be the furthest we can go. That's fine. Meanwhile, let's just sort of hold the rest of the galaxy best we can.
Unit in production.
That's Lorinar.
Hypervelocity gun destroyed.
Lorinar is always getting conquered. Like, it's just its main pastime. Severed Fleet, you are moving out. Calamari, okay, so while we're doing this, I believe we should commit ourselves to bolstering the defenses of all that we own. It is not enough to simply take these sectors. I think we should reinforce them. Droman Kos, definitely in need of some defending.
Beginning construction.
Okay, good. Victory classes are being built. Star Destroyers are being constructed. Apes Cluster is getting an extra coat of paint. Game is lagging because my scouting fleet is kind of existing in between the borders of reality, as is its wont.
Tactical battle imminent.
And there's Column X. Looks like Quint gets to be the guy on top of the stack today. Congratulations, Quint. You get to have your face shown. All right, first real fight of the day, and it's going to be a landslide victory for me. Actually, you know what? Let's not bring in the Praetor yet. Let's bring in me.
Go.
There I am. Actually, let's bring in the entire trifecta.
Moving out.
We're kind of a triumvirate, really.
On our way.
Bomber standing by.
Activated. Command set. Delete them. Don't let them escape. Attacking.
Corellian Drift standing by.
Alright.
TIE Fighter here. TIE Fighter over. Course set.
Quint, send in the storm. Rose, you're on defensive duty. If they got anything stronger than a Corvette, you are to destroy them.
Ready.
Hey, let's look at the swarm. Oh, it's good to be back.
I'm here.
What's going on?
What is it?
Enemy fire coming in.
Standing by, sir.
Die swarm, destroy them.
You good?
We are in range!
Look out, a triple
lead. That'll make our double body here.
What do you need?
Hey, Quint, drive by him.
Get on those fighters.
Time for a walk.
Hit him with the hit and run.
Approaching sound barrier.
What's next?
Drive by heel. There you go. Good job. Good job. Get out of there. Nice drift, nice drift.
Getting a lock.
Closing on target. Engines are malfunctioning.
I'm jamming the target.
I'm on them.
Sensors out. I'm flying by.
Going after them, sir.
They won't limit it. Report it.
Okay, exception. Get ready for the debuff.
Lights out.
Very good.
Go. Moving out.
At the ready.
Rose, get in. Short range. Obliterate them.
I'm ready.
Turning to your position.
CD on call, what's up?
I'm being jammed!
Defenders, get in there, destroy the attacking forces. Swarm is cleaning up house. Station is down, they are running. Mission complete.
They're not going anywhere.
Hello?
Hey. Laser them.
Hi, this is Rose.
Oh, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. Oh, there's that Corvette. Oh, just barely missed it. First win of the day. No time to wait, though. We gotta get to Rakata Prime and fast. Keep moving. Ringo, Vinda, they've got stations all along there. I don't care. Calamari Sector, keep building up, get your defenses running.
Building started. Tactical battle imminent.
Ringo Vinda, we are beginning. Now, I don't have the old rule set for this campaign, but the basic idea is that I need one of my three custom-built hero units to be in a battle or in orbit of a planet in order to play that battle. Otherwise, I am forced to auto-resolve. This gives a very explicit statement of delegation. What fights I do and don't fight are based explicitly on who's there to fight it. Now for this one, we're going to go on the opposite side of the extreme and bring in the Praetor. Ain't it just the greatest, huh? You know what? Why not? Bring in a Diamond Boron Kuat Heavy Ordnance broadside cruiser. Obliterate them. Missiles away. Wait for it, wait for it. Detonate? Oh, that's gonna put some ouch into their bones. Kuat Heavy Ordnance Diamond Boron's about to deliver your monthly supply of bone-hurting juice. Through the barrel of a missile. The missiles are actually soda cans, is what the juice is inside.
Preparing to move in.
Jamming the target.
Your bones are about to hurt. Yeah, this thing ain't. This is not a fight. This is removing an obstacle in our way.
Good morning.
You do not have a permit to build a space station here. It's being repossessed by the void.
Watch where you're flying!
Blasted nerf herders.
Oh yeah, I forgot the Praetor has overcharged batteries. Man, we're just a ship on top of some terrain, huh?
We have a priority signal coming in.
They're falling back.
Watch out for each other.
A little closer, a little closer. There we go. And that's a win. Okay. No time to dawdle.
Imperial 2 Star Destroyer standing by.
Imperial 2, go take Doran real quick for me. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Heading for coordinates.
Take Lantilles. Lantilles just got control conquered. And you know, while you're building Imperial 2s, how about you continue the tradition by building Imperial 2s?
Tactical battle imminent.
Ah, now here's a fight worth fighting. Classic Zinge. Not Warlord Zinge, the other one. His mom, I think. Dude.
Choose your reinforcements.
All right, you want to fight? Here. Let's have a fight. Rose, you're taking command.
Moving out.
Imperial 2's inbound.
What's up?
Rose mode, go.
It's Rose.
Closing on target.
What do you want?
Enemy.
Stay in formation.
Call in the search and rescue team.
What is your
now?
I'm on the way.
Beware of that direction.
Hey Rose, be careful. I know you're extremely powerful, but you are not indestructible. You're actually very destructible. That's like your one weakness. They are out of there. Cool. Minor fleet of the Republic hardliners casually obliterated. Ain't that night? Ain't that night? Ain't that day? It's not a good day for you, buddy.
Construction complete.
Okay, looks like we have a free. What the frick? Oh, there are, like, legitimate hostiles there, huh?
All crew, abandon ship.
Well, that stinks. It looks like the Imperial Hardliners are set to destroy the Separatists. No, sorry, that's the Imperial Defectors about to destroy the Separatist holdouts. All these, like, statements after what they actually are is confusing. The Hardliners, the holdouts, the Defectors, it's all just a lot to remember, huh? Okay, production in this sector of the galaxy is good, is good, is good, is good, is also not very bad. That said, Scarif and Both Camino, not Bothly, you've got some production to produce, don't you? Don't you? I know you do. I believe in you. Colomix. Oh, the corporate sector is fighting against the defectors too. That's neat. Oh, yeah, they're pushing in. This might actually help us defend our territories out here, huh? Anyway. Clear out a door, and we need this space to put in a battle force. Oh, this is the good battle music. Chaunty. Okay, so this is like a legitimate threat, and I will act accordingly. Start with the heart of the operation, the Praetor.
Right away.
Include myself, Quint, and Rose for good composition. Alright, here, this is a real fight. We need to take this seriously. TIE Swarm. Destroy the enemy bomber squadrons. Praetor, take up the bulk of defensive operations. Exception, you have the range and the firepower.
What's going on?
Proceed. Rose, you most certainly do not and are being tracked a bit. TIE Swarm, actually, go after the tractor beams on that Imperial too. We need Rose's safety. Rose's weakness is already movement, and we do not want that doubled down on. Actually, Praetor, you've got forward-facing torpedo launchers. Hit the ISD too. Very good. Rose is now free. Move back. TIE Swarm, engage. They really don't have much in terms of squadrons, but I'm leaving nothing to chance. They are running. We can't stop them from running, but they are running.
Activating. Attack.
I mean, they know what's good for them, I guess. Got the Bizarros!
Losing control!
Get on those fighters! And it's a dangerous area!
See you later. Okay, so they're gonna be back, but I don't care. They're on the way. More importantly, it should be a clear shot to Rakata Prime now.
Moving into position.
The die has been cast. Let it fall where it may.
Captain of the Mark II, standing by.
Beginning construction. Building started. Building under construction.
That's Commodore. Unfortunately, we cannot contest. Legally. Pragmatically, we could bring in this pair of ISDs, but legally, we can do nothing. And I don't particularly care, to be perfectly honest. It's not really my place. I'm just building up sort of an unrelenting mob of Imperial IIs to conquer the galaxy. I'm falling into the same psychological trap that the old Empire of old in the past did. But it's cool, I'm cool with it. Like, this ISD can go full Doran in tactical,
building under construction.
Tactical reinforcement. Zagir is good. Korriban is good. Let's get some Hvelkans. A good set of Hvelkans can help defend any planet. I do love me a good ground-based orbital laser. Seems like an oxymoron, but no.
Imperial II Star Destroyer.
It's ground-based in that it's on the ground, and it's an orbital laser in that it lasers things in orbit. That's the premise.
Building started.
I think we've got time to boost up Alatine. Here it is. The severed fleet.
Enemy fleet approaching.
Oh. Bothawi, huh? Oh, you're playing for keeps, huh?
Tactical battle imminent.
Well, that's the Dorne fight, which we can't fight. It's a win, though.
We have the coordinates.
Tactical battle imminent.
Commonore ground invasion, also out of my jurisdiction. Okay, so that is, stronger of a force than I was expecting. But this is all just prelude. It's time for the main event. Rakata Prime, space battle imminent. To all of you who don't know, it is my great honor to introduce you to the one, the only, introducing the Starforge. Pause this, let's get some dramatic reading off of here. The Starforge is the glory of the Builders, the apex of their infinite empire. It is a machine of invincible might, a tool of unstoppable conquest. The Starforge can construct Old Republic-era ships. To feed it new schematics, upgrade your Stark base at Rakata Prime. Shield points? Question mark. Hit points? Question mark. Garrison, unending reinforcements of Sith Starfighter squadrons to at 32 at a time, and Sith Interdictor cruisers 6 at a time. Destroy the hangars to stop the relentless waves. This is a boss fight. Okay, so we need a plan for this fight all on its own. It's cooking the star. Okay. So the entire thing is just belted on all sides with guns and hangars. We really can't destroy the hangars specifically because that would require us to destroy the entire freaking thing. So my plan is to do this systematically. Start on one side of the Starforge and then move across the surface in like a wave of forward-facing firepower, as is the benefit of Imperial doctrine. Given all of the enemy forces of the general garrison are over here, it is my desire to start on the opposite side. So we will begin with what will be the bulwark that we use to push forward and our major, like, tank in a sort of raid boss kind of setting, the Praetor. This thing is designed to just be the mainstay of the battle. Big, bulky, hard to destroy. Then we will have myself and hold on, let me just cancel that real quick. Myself and Rose will be on DPS duty, skirting along the edge of the chasm in order to destroy all of the hard points. Rose will be on short range DPS really close to the surface. I will be pelting artillery down to further targets at a safe range. Finally, Quint will be in charge of the squadron repel. They have a lot of Sith fighters, and the interdictors are going to be a pain.
On our way.
For that, we need nothing short of the swarm itself. Let us begin.
Ready.
Hello. It's fight time.
Rose, you have range. Destroy that Sith interdictor. It's basically your ship, but not as good. Praetor, just sort of sit there. Thank you very much.
Losing control.
Stay on target.
I'm here.
Careful, Roth, you're taking hits. Okay, it looks like the Praetor's missiles are punching through, so we can take out individual hardpoints and reduce their damage in this area. Yep, see, there are the Praetor missiles.
Shield's almost gone.
Okay, Rose and I just raw DPS. Just take it down best you can. I think the Sith interdictors are actually, like, hiding within the barrier of the Starforge's hull. They're kind of stuck in the hangar hitting us. No worry. We'll break them down soon enough.
Engines are malfunctioning.
How's the Starforge shields looking? I need tactical visual. The Starforge shields have been taken out, unless that's the Praetor shield. No, that's the Starforge. Starforge shields are down. Destroy hard points. Start clearing the way.
Engines are malfunctioning.
Rose, you appear to be getting hits on the Sith interdictor. Very good. Exception, keep moving forward. Take out those longer, hard to reach hard points. Praetor, start rotating towards the star, to the Starforge's front. Prepare to move out. We've got a lot of hard points ahead of us. Where is the TIE swarm? Corellian Drift, where are you? Standing by? Good.
Ready for orders.
Move in slightly.
Engaging drift thrusters.
Oh my goodness, the Starforge has been firing missiles at the swarm. Their AoE has been decimating us.
Just lost my targeting system.
Get them to a safe distance.
Oh. On our way.
Quinn, rotate around, get your missiles to bear. Actually,
to win the squadron game.
Deploy your heal. Thank you very much. Where are the missiles coming from? There. Center of this hull. Center of the core. Okay, a little more and the entire right wing of the Starforge will be destroyed. Okay. Praetor, move up.
Daylight limited, reporting.
Daylight limited, hold position. Destroy those last two batteries. Rose, how's destroying that interdictor going? Still hold up in the hole? Another volley of missiles coming in from the center of the Starforge.
TIE fighter here.
Praetor is taking hits. Its shields are holding, but its hull is battered. I think the missiles are the only thing breaking it. Okay, Praetor, move forward. Give us some space. Daylight limited. Return to standard operation and move forward. We need more targets in your range. Rose, you can't, you know you can't hit them, right? Like, they're in the wall?
Hi, this is Rose.
Yeah, Rose, can you just, like, move forward, please?
Lasers outgoing. If you say so.
Okay, we'll move you up. Praetor, move in.
I'm ready.
Get ready for, like, in, like, offensive wave two.
What's up?
We're still here.
Hey, it's Corellian
Drift standing by.
Okay, it looks like a good chunk of the Sith forces are inside the Starforge. Which is bad because we can't hit them, but good because they're far away.
What do you want?
Okay, Rose, fire away.
The Rose is on its way.
Keep moving along. Praetor, keep moving forward. We want you to take the hits.
Rose here.
Actually, Rose, stop moving.
Ready.
Daylight limited, move forward. Corellian Drift, you are in reserve.
Here. What is it? Out.
It's kind of hard to actually order to move because so much of the screen is taken up by attacking the Starforge orders.
But Let them escape.
You have range. You have range. This thing is gigantic. It puts the Praetor to shame. My word. You know, for as jank as it is, that is a pretty cool shot. Okay. Praetor is taking hits on the hull, but that is absolutely fine. That's what it's made to do. A head full. A head full. Rose, what are you hitting? Oh, I think the interdictors have come out of their shields. They're now attacking us from the rear. Where is the TIE swarm?
What's going
what
on?
Do you need?
CD, where are you at?
TIE fighter, over.
TIE swarm. Attack the interdictors.
I'll take them myself.
At the ready.
Rose, you are in danger. Move
right,
ahead.
Besties, turn that away.
You good?
Exceptions. Rose, move up, move up. Get inside the shield generator, shield hole area of the Praetor. You are not to be taking damage hits like that. Okay, good. You dodged the missiles. Well done.
Daylight Limited reporting.
Exception, how you doing? Moving along the hull. Very good, very good. Redirect attack target. Wait, Exception, are you firing at the interdictors over there? Or the starfighters, maybe? Yes, you are. Okay, good. That interdictor's taken down. No more should spawn back here because we destroyed all the hangars along the way. Rose, halt your forward advance. Praetor, move in.
We crushed them.
Enemy fighters incoming.
Target.
Okay, back to command.
Hi, this is Rose.
Rose, move forward.
Nice to be.
Ready to go.
To shake them. What's up?
Pew pew.
I'm ready. Okay, it looks like we've carved across almost half of the Starforged surface. We're halfway there, but most of the enemy's reserves are still available.
Channel open.
Looks like a lot of starfighters are attacking over
What's
here.
Next?
Quint, I am relocating you two over here. I think it's a better position for you tactically.
Hey,
we're still
it's
here.
Rose.
Careful. Move in.
There's a bandit on your tail.
Lining up for the kill.
So it seems that my Rose mode, like firing rate, combined with my slow speed, is actually a good combination for slowly arcing across the surface of the Starforge. I think it's like optimal, or at least near so.
What do you want?
Okay, Rose, you're forward. Let's move you closer to hostile targets.
Moving out.
That said, I want the Praetor to keep going.
Pushing forward.
Rallying Drift going good.
TIE fighter here.
The TIE Swarm is keeping the Starfighters busy. That is exactly what they're intended to do.
Just lost my targeting system. Just lost my targeting system.
Getting a lock.
Rose, I did not declare you close enough yet. Praetor, keep moving. Praetor, move in.
Ready.
Exception. Switch to speed. Get in close. New TIE Swarm dropped. Engage the interdictors.
What's going on?
Rose, be careful. You are in the hot seat.
At the ready.
Actually, engage Rose mode. We need you to stop.
Hold on, let me get my popcorn.
Rose, take out the interdictor.
Hey, besties. Mess up their gravity well generators.
I'm here. Gravity? Do you believe in gravity?
Praetor, keep moving forward.
Ready for orders.
Actually, Quinn, how you doing? You're getting a good, like, front row seat to all this happening in relative safety. Oh boy, there's a lot of ships behind us. Okay.
What is it? You good?
Stay on target.
Attack.
Alright, that's it. Exception. Destroy the hostiles behind us. Eliminate them. You're our rear guard now.
Proceeding with mission. Number 5 craft.
Daylight limited reporting.
You know, exception, I think now is the perfect opportunity for a debuff.
Pack their wires.
Yes, Commander.
I'm ready.
Enemy fighters. Stay here.
Fire. Hit them.
Roger. Beginning my firing run.
Fill them with payload.
One of them escaped.
Delete them.
Standing by, sir.
Hi, Swarm, get back here.
Changing to intercept course.
Activated.
Stay in formation.
Ready.
Okay, I think we're getting a little tense over here. Rose, how you doing? Praetor, halt movement. Starforge, remaining health, hard points at 92%. Daylight Limited is alone.
I'm here. Gravity. Don't let them escape.
Exception, you are taking damage. Move out. Get out of there.
We've lost 10. I've lost my warhead launchers.
Hi, this is Rose.
Rose, you're still firing? Okay.
There they are. What is it?
Oh, that ain't good.
CD on call, what's up? We're on it.
Approaching sound barrier!
Winds, get here!
Coming through!
I need assistance fast.
You good?
Losing control!
Reporting?
Quint in with the rescue. Go, go, go.
Ready for orders. All right, if you say so. We're on the way. Time for a walk.
Heavy fire. I can't take it.
We'll try it. Sure.
Close enough.
Engaging drift thrusters.
Stay on target.
On our way.
Daylight Limited reporting.
I can't.
Ready to go.
Attack formation.
Moving out.
Okay, I think the Daylight Limited's out of the fight.
What's up?
Bro, oh no.
It's fighting time. Paddle to the metal.
Rose, get out of there, please.
I'm taking serious damage.
Get back to the Praetor.
Losing power.
If you say so.
Rose, I don't think you're surviving this. I'm sorry.
Hey, it's Rose.
I can't switch position. Locking new course.
Wait, I have a weird idea. It might not work, but it might work.
What do you want?
I'm ready.
Let's kick it.
Rosier.
Ready to recon the area.
I think this might work. Then again.
What's going on?
Standing by, sir.
I've got my eye on
the drone's getting restless.
They're on me.
At the ready.
We're still here.
Hello.
Activated.
Hi, this is Rose.
Ready. You are about to have a skill issue.
Rose, get behind me!
What's up?
I'm here. Go. Move out. Attacking. Heading out.
Hey, it's Rose. The Rose is on its way. Alright, besties, turn that away.
What is it?
Trying to win the squadron game.
We good? Careful.
Preparing to move in.
Okay.
Corellian Drift standing by.
Okay.
Go after the stragglers.
Ready to recon the area.
The flags are sustained.
Target locked.
Praetor. Keep taking aggro. Okay, Daylight Limited, your sole job is to defend you and the other two leaders. Rose, you're on standby for rapid fire weapons.
What do you need?
Quit, you have missiles and emergency squadrons if we need them. Exception, take advantage of your range. Good hit.
I'm on them. Getting a lock.
I'll take care of this.
Praetor, how you doing?
Engines are malfunctioning.
Where's the censorship? There's the censorship.
The crew's getting restless.
Censorship, I have a job for you, and it entirely involves you getting blown the heck up. Okay, new swarm has just been unlocked. Very good, very good. Keep them at range. Praetor is losing shields. Exception, good.
I'm under heavy fire.
Censorship, where are you?
Captain here, my
lord.
Yeah, can you stop not taking damage, please? This entire plan hinges on your temporary destruction.
Standing by, sir.
Okay, we've gotten through the core of the Star Forge, now it's just the left wing. We can do this.
Stay in formation.
TIE fighter in position.
I'm being down.
Praetor's hull integrity is dropping. since their ship is still in the shadow of the Praetor, I believe.
Ready to recon the area.
Yep, there it is. Should be emerging soon.
Channel open.
Losing power.
Crew 5, head back to the Daylight Limited. Praetor Hull at 50%, shields at nothing. We can do this.
TIE fighter here.
Are standing by.
Yeah.
On our way. Heading for coordinates.
Enemy in range.
Praetor, hold position. Open fire at this position. Sensor ship. Operation modular change is underway.
TIE fighter, over. They're in my sights.
TIE swarm, you've been tailed. Eliminate them.
Forming on your wing.
Captain here, my lord.
Okay, good. Sensor ship is now taking damage. Without, keep him at bay. Praetor Hull at 1/3. Passport cruiser is taking damage, shields at half.
Ready to recon the area.
I think this is gonna work. Praetor, maintain fire on the Starforge. That is your target.
You're being double teamed.
Okay. We can do this. We can do this. It's being done. The Starforge will fall.
Daylight Limited reporting. Ready to go.
Captain here, my lord.
Sensor ship shields are down. Hull is taking damage. This is very good. Praetor Hull integrity critical. Praetor is critical. All units evacuate. All personnel, evacuate, evacuate, evacuate. Modular Task Force Cruiser has fallen. Praetor soon to follow. Modular Task Force Cruiser is down. Bring in the repair cruiser.
Bring us around.
The Praetor is down. Repeat, the Praetor is down. Begin phase two. Launch! 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 The Star Destroyers have arrived! Star Destroyers, all fire! Destroy the Star Forge immediately! Hostiles converging on the command fleet. Daylight Limited, take him out.
fighter here.
Thai swarm, come back to the command fleet.
Enemies in range.
We have a target.
What do you What's next? Want? Ready for orders?
What would you like? That's all my warhead.
Your group four. I'm group one.
What is your closing on target?
Very good, very good. Excellent, excellent. Destroyer, move in. Get in range of the final hard points. Focus on hangars as we destroy the last bits of the enemy's interdictor fleet. We want to make sure that they do not recover. Swarm 5, get back to the command fleet. Okay, last hangar on that edge destroyed. Focus here. Another interdictor inbound. Star destroyers line up. Hostile interdictors moving in towards the command fleet. Daylight limited, destroy them. Keep them at bay, you still have your guns.
My scopes are jammed.
Hangar down. Final hard point.
Up on your wing.
Activated.
Beginning my firing run.
Forming on your wing.
The Starge Forge has been neutralized. All units, target the interdictor fleet.
Ready.
Rosier.
I'm here.
Pack him.
Have you tried turning it off and on again?
Standing by, son.
Swarm 5, get here.
I'll deal with the scum.
What is it?
Interdictor down.
Do you believe in ground? Ready to go. I'm ready.
Tie fighter here.
Enemy
still here. Activated. Gravity.
CD on call, what's up?
New swarm, get in there! Hold the line! All interdictors destroyed. It's just the starfighters now.
Rotate
slightly.
Ready.
Okay, there's a large part of the swarm milling about over there. Not too big of a problem. Star Destroyers, move in, engage them, keep them busy. Clean them up.
TIE fighter here. Changing to intercept course.
I'm here.
Closing on target.
Yeah, we're clipping into the Star Forge's former existence. That's fine. This is a prepare for boarding.
Lambda shuttle ready. Arming weapons.
Interceptor squad reporting for the Empire.
Huh. I think we did it. I think we managed to pull through. We lost the Praetor, but I expected to lose the Praetor. That got real close, but I think we managed to save everyone. Yeah, I'd like them to not be inside the Star Forge anymore, please. Thank you. Looks like the last bit of squadrons are fighting along the rim of the Star Forge back here. Interesting.
What is it?
Time for the mighty to fall.
Reporting.
Now, an homage to those who made it all possible. It is done.
I've got them on my scopes. Eliminating target.
Here's to the leaders of the severed fleet.
Ready to recon the area. Plotting new course.
We good? So, why haven't we won yet? Anything left to take down? Ah, yeah, there's one. Cool.
Ready for orders. We're on it.
Coming through!
At the ready. On the double.
Cleaning up anything left, anything at all. You know what? I think we have the room for another scout ship.
Yes, sir.
Let's see if we can see. I detect nothing. In that case, it might just be for the best that we retreat, come back, and take the land.
Entering hyperspace.
We are clear to go. It is done. The Star Forge has been destroyed. All right.
Captain of the Mark II standing by.
Now you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna take the Brentau fleet of army and just bring it over, conquer the place. Bothwe battle. Bad but inevitable. Okay, back to our regularly scheduled production of a bunch of ISD-2s, if you don't mind. The Severed Fleet is about to reform on Jeddah, it would seem. And from there, we will head back to the corporate sector, assuming no other major catastrophes happen. We should be clear. That said, you will want to go there. You can stay here.
Mark 2 online.
In fact, you both can stay there. We don't need that. I'll lead the fleet. Alright. Through the corporate sector. Or at least the closest thing on the line to get there. To Lantilles. Good evening to you. I missed that message. I apologize. Looks like the attack fleet is about to arrive. Manan is under siege. Unfortunately, nothing we can do except auto-resolve there. Taking Bothwe. I knew they would take Bothwe.
Production started.
Imperial 2 Star Destroyer standing by.
I wouldn't know for this game because this is an old save that we need to finish off the campaign for. This is still in the 32-bit version, but I have played the 64-bit version, and it is going surprisingly well. I wouldn't say that there's like a big performance improvement because it's just increasing the number of addresses available, but things are not crashing. They're not freezing. I can watch a multiplayer skirmish match between 3-on-3 with a million squadrons, and the game does not freeze. Yeah, no desyncs. It's been great. Okay, where's the Severed Fleet? Severed Fleet is moving out. Gila Sector. Okay, that's going to take a bit. The invasion fleet for Rakata Prime is on its way. In the meantime, I think just bolster up the defenses at our sectors, make sure nobody takes them.
Building under construction.
No simplistic army like that.
Beginning construction.
Get buildings up and running. Get those factories. Also, hello LMG Pro, sorry I didn't mention that earlier. You did show up. Rakata Prime invasion. It's nothing special. Rakata Prime is ours. And you know, for bonus points, maybe bring this pre-built attack force and take out Jeddah and Elam. Maybe read out, maybe Utigu. Not really my priority at this moment. My priority is taking the corporate sector, and then we win.
Tactical battle imminent.
Toydaria. I have a question. Is chat showing up here? I can't tell. Try typing something real quick. Okay, it is. Sorry. I was a little worried. Nope, it's just me reading messages before or after they already disappear. No worries, just my own fault. Apes Cluster is fully defended, which is good because Zeltros is barreling down. We're gonna get to Lantilles, the Roach Asteroid, Ringo Vinna. We have a few notable hostile forces in the way, but nothing that should stop us. Corporate sector has not reinforced. Should be good. Lentilles, the Republic is back. All right, you want to fight me? Fight me. Man, it's so much less stressful when the Starforge is already destroyed.
Move in.
Let's see, to really take a breath of fresh air. A sigh of relief.
Stay close.
And stealing the oxygen from the enemy's hull. Give me an Imperial too. Much appreciated. Oh, there you are. Slow your roll, we got more ISDs. Where that come from? And quit.
We're on the way.
Get in there. Very good.
Standing by, sir.
High swarm movement.
I'll deal with this scum.
Imperials, begin bombardment. Exception?
I'm ready.
Take your time. I understand you're not the fastest ship in the fleet. Fair enough, fair enough.
We're still here.
Full salvo! Rose mode.
Activated.
I'm on a gun.
This game is, as it always has been, very beautiful.
Ready. Attack.
Destroy the station, send them running. Their petty squabbles are of no interest to us. We are dealing with a galactic ambition.
I'm here. Moving out.
Targeted.
Go. What is it? Lights out.
It's a bandit making a run at you.
Station down. Clear up the stragglers. This chump thinks he can get away, and guess what? He's right. Oh wait, no tractor. Ah, the tractor beam does not help with hyperspace.
No matter.
Okay, we are going to have a collection of mildly meaningful fights in between here and the corporate sector. Tordaria has fallen.
System lost.
That is fine.
Go.
At this point, it's a matter of time.
Tactical battle imminent.
Proceed. I would auto-resolve a lone station fight, but I legally cannot.
We good? Daylight Limited reporting.
First person mode activated.
Ready to go. Move out.
Third person.
We are the vanguard of the fleet.
What in the world? Why the heck is there a default voice line in here? Oh, it's because it's the command for going into the asteroid belt. Or asteroid field. Wow. Final stream of the campaign and I've discovered a glitch.
Heading out.
That is incredible. Well, good thing I don't need this mod anymore. 5.0 will come out eventually and I'll port everything over. Pro Crusader's getting a redesign for its gameplay style. I'll have to adapt accordingly.
Careful.
As a general recap for anyone who's wondering about the custom heroes I built, such as myself here, the basic design principle behind our three ships, which I shall jointly bring in so I can describe them all.
On our way.
I've got places to be.
I'm ready.
So my ship is basically a Pro Crusader with improved range and vision, and the middle of the quad turbo lasers instead has a heavy octuple ion cannon. So it's a bit of a compromise between the regular Pro Crusader and the shield breaker variant. Quint's customized Confalk, the Corellian Drift.
Hello!
Is basically a regular Corellian Drift, or a regular Tonfalk, except it hosts the TIE Swarm and is stupidly fast.
We're on the way.
It's got like a default speed of 6, and then the boost ability quadruples it. Maximum drift.
Time for a walk.
Like if I just...
Approaching sound barrier!
Sure.
And off he goes! Like, it is ridiculous the amount of speed he has.
Trying to win the squadron game.
And it is also ridiculous just how dead he is. Oh no. Quint, get out of there.
On our way.
While Quint gets to safety, moving on to finally Rose in Rose. Name of the ship, name of the person, both the same. It is a formerly Vindicator, now Enforcer.
Huh?
Ty, this is Rose.
With Ty Bizarro's as a garrison and Rose mode. For reduction of speed to 25% normal, all the guns shoot just like a... just a water hose of lasers. It's 10 times the fire rate, but like 1/4 the damage. Not 1/4. The math run... yeah, okay. It actually says it right here. I can just read it. Yeah. Rate of fire multiplied by 10. Damage per shot and engine power are reduced. It's quadruple damage for 1/4 speed, effectively.
We're still here.
My ship got upgraded to be a Procrastinator with a hangar due to the power of friendship with Quint, and to have its own variant of Rose mode due to the power of friendship with Rose. Instead of doing the... Quint?
What's up?
Corellian Drift standing by.
You okay?
TIE Fighter, over. Stay on target.
You know what? I can no longer do exposition. I need to save Quint. Hold on. Due to their nature, Rose and Quint are both kind of glass cannons.
What's next?
Quint is hyper fragile but very fast. Rose is super lethal but only at extremely close range. The effect makes them very risky to use, which pairs well with the fact that if they get destroyed in battle, I can't control the fleet anymore. I, however, being a coward, am in a highly bulky long-range ship, which is, decreased risk, but also decreased price of failure. Because if I'm destroyed, I can't do anything on the galactic map.
Hey,
CD on call, what's up?
What do you want?
Ready.
Anyway, let's finish this fight before I lose anything else that's too really, really dumb.
Falling out of formation.
Standing by, sir.
Rose here.
You doing okay, Quint? You're, many parts of your ship are currently on fire. But you have your shields and you have your engine, so you're good to go.
What is your... the shield generator's
under control. Yeah, got it.
I thought you said you were an ace. Yes, Commander.
Forming on your wing.
I gotta bail you out again.
Terminal open.
Nice swarm move in.
TIE Fighter copies.
I'm on three. Authorization.
You're coming in.
Enemies in range.
Deflecting designated target.
I'll take number four.
Intercept those strike fighters before they launch their warhead.
I need assistance fast.
That's a dangerous area.
Now there's some classic Imperial might for you. It's a beautiful thing. All right, what's keeping us from winning? I would like to know.
Getting a lock. I'll get the missile.
stations down. Destroy all remaining forces. Quint, you still good? Yeah, you still good. Nice explosion. You're Z fighting with yourself, chump. Look at these Imperial defectors. Can't even Z fight their own station, right? You know, my stations, they got proper clipping. Show you the might of the real Empire. Get these fakers out the door. Out of here. Thank you very much.
System control achieved. Constructed.
Okay, given the near disaster that was almost losing Quint on that last mission, I'm going to run this one by the book. Level 2 station Ringo Vinda, no other support. We are going to send in the Star Destroyers and clean them up nice and easy. Though, as much as this is technically an obstacle in our way, this whole thing is basically a victory lap. What kind of mysteries are going on out here?
Reporting. Stay close.
Okay, first, third person mode, go.
Command set. Moving out. Go.
Coming.
There they are.
Fire. Move out. Heading out. Careful. Hit them.
Full salvo. Star Destroyers, please load in. Thank you very much.
I'm ready.
Okay. Pack them.
Pack their wires. Still here.
And it's destroyed. Missile soon to be down. Our shields are up and they're running out of bombers.
Shields down.
Shields are down, but so are they.
Nothing can stop the Empire.
Clean win. Should have a few easier fights because this territory is sort of a in conflict with opposing enemy forces, so they haven't really had the time to reinforce.
Heading out.
We might face an army, but that's actually easier for us to deal with. Yeah, like Column X is empty.
Go.
Liana should be a walk in the park.
Tactical battle imminent.
They do have some forces, but we have a lot more. Ooh, lovely cloudscape. I love this skybox.
Activated. Move in.
I think this is my favorite map. Anyway, no time to get distracted.
Ready.
We have a fight to fight. Star Destroyers inbound. In a few seconds, they gotta render.
Making best possible speed. We come across enemy units.
Bombers at the ready. Engines activated.
Goodness me, Exception. Today you are just being way too aggressive on these fights, huh?
Man. Yes, sir. Moving the engine palace estate.
Yeah, that's a good move in.
What is your move?
What is it? You're about to have a skill issue.
Overwhelm them. Bring in a Venator just for the fun of it. We could use a bit of a battle carrier.
Good. Fill them with payload. They'll eat them.
Okay. Space over Liana secured.
Pursuing rebel forces.
Severed fleet, you are clear to leave.
The enemy has been defeated.
The rebels are on the run.
Nicely done.
Construction complete.
Druckenwell? How dare you? Well, while the Imperial Remnant are busy taking Pyrrhic victories, we have a fight to fight. Whoa! Okay. Huh. What's this about? Oh boy, something's up. Corporate sector making a last minute play for relevance. I respect it.
We will go there.
But all this means is that they will be taking on the full brunt of all that I have to throw at them.
Advancing.
The comms are yours.
Ahead. The plan is simple as can be. Exception buffs vision for all frigates and capitals. Might actually just be all units. I don't remember exactly. I'll check my engineering team later. The ISDs have the longest vision range in the fleet, and we will use that to give the broadsides vision of their targets at extreme range.
Mark 2, standing by. Drive system online.
A Light Limited reporting.
The enemy appears to have something. I don't quite recognize the silhouette on the map. It's very thin.
What would you have us do?
My immediate thought is Dauntless class, maybe a recusant.
Commander.
Not sure.
What is your command?
Move in for surround, exception. We want you on artillery support. I guess. Is artillery really the right word? It's just like long range fire support. The real artillerizing is going to be done by our broadside diamond boron variant, of course, because I am classy with the classy missiles.
I'm ready.
Oh, eager to shoot, are you? Okay, let's see here. We have a victory class. And I was right, that is a recusant. But the initial salvo is away.
We're still here.
You will be inconvenienced by that fact.
Stay close.
What are your orders?
Hold position here. It said hold position here. Stop not holding position there, you chump. There we go. Have missiles connected. No, but they're about to. 3-0. Okay, I don't know what I hit, but we probably hit something. Second volley of missiles is away. Recusants moving into our side. Star Destroyers, engage. If they want to play hanky-flanky, I'll let them play hanky-flanky. I'm not just going to wait around. Keep everything in reserve. This is unquestionably a siege. If they want to play it like this, we'll play it like this. Squadrons are moving in. Interceptors. Rebuff them. Next missile salvo moving in. Large collection of units. Will they connect? Appear to have fired a bit behind them. Redirect onto the victory class that appears to be the heart of their formation.
Good kill.
Back around. Okay, this salvo is going to decide a lot.
What would you have us do?
Star Destroyers, maximum firepower. Exception, move into Rose mode and prepare to hack. Salvo is diverging. Do we have detonation? Yes, we do. Hacking range, optimal.
Have you tried turning it off and on again?
Very good. That's a transport. Okay, both hero units are in victory classes. That's good intel.
Yes, sir. Advancing on target.
Interceptors attack the squadrons. Forward Star Destroyer. Keep up the attack.
You're coming in here.
Damage here. Designated target.
Comms are yours.
Uptake number 3.
Salvo is good. Repeat, salvo is good.
Escape.
Daylight limited focus on the, what is this called? The Widow's Wail. Star Destroyers focus on the Enforce. They have a special ion cannon on that thing? Magpulse missiles. I see. Concerning.
You good? Attacking.
Daylight limited redirect fire onto this acclimator. The recusant is far away from the battle. The dreadnought is actually flanking us. Star Destroyer on the right edge. Rotate and engage. Firepower at full. Leftmost Star Destroyer. Star Destroyer 3, move into the station. Fighters are being cleaned up. Daylight limited. Rotate, destroy the dreadnought. Star Destroyer 2, hold back and recover shields.
I'm ready.
Daylight limited, your work here is done. Move forward, attack the station. Star Destroyer 2, once your shields are back online, I want you to engage the recusant. Fighter's clean. Star Destroyer 4, hunt down the recusant. Star Destroyer 2, get ready to join. Wait for the ions to wear off.
Still here. Moving out.
Rose mode engaged, full fire on station. The recusant has gone off the board. Star Destroyer 2, your shields will recover on the trip. Move out. Broadside still firing. Fire is pretty ineffective at this point. The siege is over. Well, no worries. The recusant will retreat regardless. And its engine's already destroyed, so it will not leave. Good job to this corporate sector being cool. Your shields are impressive, but no match for my octuple turbo laser battery array. I've got four of them to a side. And their azimuth control is phenomenal. I can shoot all eight of them at you if I try. Add in a little bit of overcharged primary battery, and we have a recipe for you turning into soup. Get souped on.
The enemy.
That is the corporate fleet annihilated in this local territory. We move on to Korriban as soon as Captain Nemoidia finishes getting conquered. Thank you very much.
Go.
Okay. It's clear to me that the Imperial territories will not hold. But all we really care about are the sectors. We take the sectors, everything goes fine.
Tactical battle imminent.
Druckenwell, again, nothing we can do. Korriban will be a fight. The Ligeria will be a fight. Corporate sector will be an invasion.
Tactical battle imminent.
Begin.
Ready. Move out.
Choose your reinforcements.
This truly is the Empire at War experience. Being in space. A planet below you. Shenanigans abound. Star Destroyers jumping in from hyperspace.
Make the best possible speed to that system.
Mach 2 standing by.
Oh, fire. Fire.
Careful.
What are your orders? Drive system online. Full speed. Take us to the target.
Full fire. Interceptors move in.
Move in.
I'll take number two.
I'll leave them.
I'm on one.
Don't let them escape.
Shields are already falling on a Star Destroyer, but they're not known for their shields.
I've got them on my scopes.
There
you go.
Defenders, move in.
Reporting.
Hack them.
Attacking.
Hangar's destroyed. Clean up.
Shields down.
Oh, no, you don't.
Targeting rebel forces.
Moving to engage.
Victory is within our grasp.
Easy.
They're falling back.
Very nice. Two planets stand Man between set. Us and absolute victory. An enemy fleet has interrupted space production at the Roche asteroids. I do not care. In case you were wondering about the level of care that I have, none.
Construction complete.
Oh, hey. Production facilities just in time for me to shoot stuff.
Move out.
They just got it to level 2. I saw that go from one station icon to two station icons. I got distracted by my station completing. I would have had a slightly easier time in this fight, but no.
Ready to go. Stay close.
Unacceptable.
Choose your reinforcements.
They hit me with the oldest trick in the book, Imperial Pride, before the Imperial Fall. And hold position.
What is your command? You heard the commander.
Today we deal with the Sith cultists and their giant collection of Auric squadrons and Sith starfighters. To help bolster this, I am bringing in Quint to help us with the TIE swarm.
Ready for orders.
TIE fighter here.
They're in my sight.
I'm ready. Do you believe in gravity?
Lock on and pressure and target. Speak to prep.
Closing on target.
Reporting. Moving to engage.
Jamming designated target.
Forming on your wing.
Engaging.
Going after them, sir. Targeting rebel forces.
That's gonna hurt.
Forming up on your wing.
Fighters.
All units move forward. We need to shoot the back half of that station if we want to destroy the station. Okay, it is time to go back to the corporate sector. Finish what we started. Finish what we already finished before but had to unfinish. It's time for the final fight. Unless, of course, we... Starforge suddenly decides to show up, or, you know, the Imperial defectors take out, like, a planet on their conquest. Point is, it is the moment of truth, number two.
Construction complete. Construction complete.
To the remade Empire. To the severed fleet. Wait, I'm a fool? This is the wrong planet. I just started an invasion of the wrong planet. Oh, that dramatic, the dramatic buildup amounting to nothing. This isn't even the right place. We got lost. Planetary shield up. You know what?
It will be my honor.
Whatever. Whatever. We're doing it. We're here. In for a penny. In for a penny, in for a pound, or, if you're American, in for a dime, in for a dollar.
Troop carrier, ready to pick up soldiers, sir? I shall contact you when we arrive, sir. Moving up.
Prepare for assignment.
Troop carrier, en route.
Nothing to it but full frontal attack. Take out the outposts. Keep moving.
I can get that. Moving out on patrol.
Oh, it looks like the locals are not happy with the local government, huh? For the outpost, keep watching. What are you? Mark IV War Droid, huh? Fascinating. It has 30 hit points, and that's all we know about it. And now it has 0 hit points.
Destroy remaining resistance.
Yeah, you think you've seen it all, but in truth, you've only really seen your sector of the galaxy, the fights you fight, the victories you take. Okay. Now that we've accidentally taken Zygeria, we can do what I meant to do.
Command set.
And take the corporate sector.
Building under construction.
Build some administration on the planet. I'm not a monster. Okay, for real this time.
Invasion commencing.
This is going to be a just absolute slugfest. We are going to be shooting each other and blowing things up. My main advantage is I've got numbers, they've got defensive positions, but I have bombardments in select locations. Let's see how this goes. We can win it once, we can win it again.
At maximum unit capacity,
the enemy is approaching.
ATPT ready, sir. I'll handle that, sir.
Following your lead.
Personal transport ready.
Choose your reinforcements.
Of course.
Tank regiment to the south, Walker regiment to the north.
Here we go.
Actually, this appears to be a skiff regiment.
Sniper, take cover! They're trying to flank us!
Capture the command post. Let us bring in our third collection of forces.
Comm channel open. Ready and able.
You are squad 2. Move up the south.
Personal transport standing by.
Spread out.
They have anti-air towers. Be advised. All right, they also have air. Just air, period. I don't really have any decent anti-air options, except maybe this command post over here and this build pad, hiding in the grass. The locals have hidden it to defend against any enemy forces that might try to be an enemy and force things. This will allow us to deal with the enemy aircraft with relative ease. Now, I'm assuming this is a stronghold, that's a stronghold, we are just going to have to fight them. Bring in Walker Regiment.
Right away, sir.
Welcome aboard, soldiers.
Oh, another one. Excellent.
Ready. Right.
That one will be a scanner node.
Construction complete.
Just avoid the heavy fire, will you?
All right. We have engaged. Missiles away. Up the hill, they have cover. Oh, we can't build a sensor thing. Oh well, more anti-air. Group 1, up the hill, take the fortress. Bombing run is available, but they do have anti-air towers. Destroy fortress. Group 1 on position, group 3, reinforce. Move in, move in. Group 1 holding steady. Heat barrage. Okay, group 2 has been destroyed. Unfortunate. Group 1 is holding steady. TIE fighters have moved into this sector. Anti-air fire upon them. Fortress destroyed. Bombardment inbound on the juggernauts. Good hit, good hit. Group 3 just in time. We need a group 2 now. Okay, there's only one TIE fighter left in the sky. Group 3 engage. Risking it with a bombing run. Wish them luck.
Initiate bombing run.
Comm channel open. Deployment zone ahead.
One move in. Group 2. Reinforce. For now, it's just group 3 in the fight. Move in, move in. Bombing run inbound. Moderate effect. Not my finest work. They got their heavy firepower. Trooper, take that build pad. We need more anti-air.
ATPT reporting.
Ping.
Yes, sir.
Good day, good day.
Okay, take them out. Group 1 is coming in. Group 2 is coming in. Group 3 has been destroyed. New Walker Regiment inbound, if you please.
Roger, pull through. Enemy sighted. Engage! We found them.
Focus fire on the Juggernaut.
We're reading you. We've got you loud and clear.
Group 3 on that Walker, don't let it escape. Very good. Group 2, move up to the north.
Issue your command, sir.
You are the new Group 3. Destroy that fortress and regroup. There are so many of them. Moving forward, get ready. The anti-air threat has been destroyed. Move on to anti-vehicles. Group 2, begin flank. Get those lasers up and running. Group 1 has fallen. Group 2, pick your targets better.
We made contact with the enemy.
Good effect, good effect. Group 3 has reached stronghold. Move in.
Take out that sniper.
Yes.
Rocket fire.
Group 1, move in. Group 2. That was a good explosion on that one. Clean him up. Target fortress. Missiles away.
I cover fast.
Bombing run inbound.
Rocket fire.
I want those rebels dead.
Juggernaut destroyed. Bombs away. Okay, good job. Group three, absolutely. Move in. Group one, move in. Group two, move in. We need a new group three.
Understood, Commander.
Fast forward as everyone gets to position. Next objective, destroy the anti-air tower. And also their shield generator, which is in the same spot. This will allow us to perform major bombardment activities. Assuming I still have some walkers. Yes, I do.
Awaiting orders. Fire!
Time to clean up the scum.
Up. Mortar scumbag fire detected.
Affirmative.
Awaiting command.
Awaiting orders. Hate the mortars. This way. Team move up. Walkers. Clear the way. ATPT unit, move closer so we can start scouting the area. Group 2, destroy the tower and the shield generator. Take your time, the bombardment isn't going anywhere. PT, you are on group 4. You are going to give us a vision of what there is to deal with. Well, nothing in that particular location. I'm convinced. Move in. Charge him.
Well done, gentlemen.
System control achieved.
It is done. It is done! The campaign is complete once more. You know what? But I'm going to do something fancy. With this dramatic accompaniment, we are going back here. Hey! We've won! This has been Star Wars Empire at War. Exception at War, Remake the Empire. The Epilogue, I suppose. The Infinite Epilogue, maybe even. We have bested the Starforge. We have seen all we have to see in this mod. You know what? You probably deserve some. See those credits still? Bit fancy, I think, but you know, it works. Thank you all for joining me on this journey. The journey of the original campaign, the journey of this particular stream, and the journey of this past year. I've reached my mark. 100 streams, 2023. It's been done. We've made it. Oh. Now, this is not to say that I'm done streaming with this year, but it does mean that I no longer feel obligated to stream this year. And I can focus on a few other non-streaming related things, like editing the video for the Empire at War series, editing the highlights for this year, and just other creative endeavors that you will see. I'm not going to make the next version of the Remake Empire exception mod submod mod thing until 5.0 comes out. And I'm going to let this rest as is until that happens, because there have been updates to the game, there have been updates to the mod, and I would like to play the fancy new 64-bit multiplayer matches with people. Maybe you. Maybe random people on the internet. Maybe other members of NTV. Mostly just whoever the heck I can get to fight me. That'd be good. Other stuff I'm doing, I don't remember. Which means I can conveniently not spoil it for you. Isn't that great? Whew, good stuff. Good stuff. I don't really have a good coherent way of signing out here. I'm Exception. This isn't TV. I've had a good time. And you know what? Just as like another line in the personal celebration, I am, the music's about to cut off. Yep, there it goes. Apologies. I have to alt-tab. Because I have just received, and by just received I mean an hour ago in the middle of the stream, a gift! And I would like to share it. If you will permit me this moment to get it gathered from the confines of data structures and other type things. I am saying random buzzwords that don't mean anything. As I stall for time, hold on. I'd like to present you a lovely gift I just received from Capra Ophon, or Capra Zerophon. This lovely celebratory image of me being a diabolical mastermind. I love it. It's great. Thank you so much. I am going to print this out and put it on Quint's wall, because I don't got a wall. I got a desktop. I'll put that there too. Thank you so much. This is like the first unsolicited piece of fan art I have ever gotten, and it means a whole lot to me. Does look really cool. Capra, I don't know if you're still here. Thank you for being like my first fan that I didn't just have already. You're wonderful. Everyone else, you're also wonderful. I'm too overloaded on wartime adrenaline to be sentimental right now, but today is a good day. I should probably put this behind the chat for convenience. There we go. Thank you so much. Whew, I am I am tired. I feel good. Happy Thanksgiving if you are a member of the United States citizenship. Happy 100th stream to me. Happy celebration of the end of the Empire at War remake, the Empire Exception at War thing. Tune in for more stuff. You are all wonderful people, and I'm happy that you have decided to choose me as the person you want to see with your eyeballs in this moment. Whether this moment live or this moment in recordings, you've made the choice to have me be the thing entering your eyes and ears and thoughts and hearts, and it means a lot that you would consider me important enough to do that. In the words of classic computer virus of old, I love you. I'm Exception. This isn't TV. Have a good day and good night.